Good morning.
Good morning.
Welcome to Hale's Corners Lutheran. I'm Pastor Leon and Pastor Keith here, and a special welcome to any guests here. This last week, this place was filled with energy. You just saw our VBS video, and we are so very blessed. Throughout the week, we had 400 students that were here in the morning, and then later in the afternoon, about 20 special needs friends, all who heard the joyous word of the Lord that Jesus is the light of the world. And so we are so very thankful for what took place. And you know, Keith, what I am most excited about from this last week of VBS are the seeds that have been planted and what the Holy Spirit is going to do with those. And I hope that we get to see some of what will take place, but I know there's lots that we won't see that's already taking place in homes and in the lives of those students, those children that were here this past weekend. So glory to God in the midst of an awesome week. Two other announcements I want to share with you. So tonight is our Festival Choir Patriotic Musical. Just a reminder, that happens at 5:30. That'll also happen on Wednesday at 6:30 in this place. So that means that our Grange worship services tonight, as well as on Wednesday, won't take place there. We're asking you to come and invite you to come to this Festival Choir Patriotic Musical. Also, just a reminder, STARS, the Women's STARS Retreat, registration for that opens July 1st.
So our Together in Mission offering last weekend, as we receive gifts from God's people for support of what we're doing in Kenya. Last weekend, we received $24,000. And so our goal for this project is to reach our three-year commitment of $100,000 this weekend. And so if you pray about that, we need to finish the year strong to the general giving, and this is the last weekend for that. But if you pray about that and you want to give toward what we're doing, what God is inspiring in Kenya, then you can use your Together in Mission envelopes in the back of the pew there and give toward that this morning as well. Also in our life together, one of the things that God inspired was a pictorial directory. Now the directory is not in yet, but the other thing is that if you ordered pictures from Life Touch, those are going to come to you in the mail. But if you didn't order pictures and all you're waiting for is your complimentary photo, that could be at the information counter in the back. So here in a little while, you're going to have an opportunity to see Chad's complimentary video up on a screen. So I know you'll really enjoy that. If you want to pick up your pictorial directory, that's going to be coming soon. But your complimentary photo, if you didn't order photos, those will be at the information counter in the back. And then finally, I want to be able to pray over some folks. We're about to, come on up here, you guys. We're about to send a team of folks to Slovakia to represent us and to be ambassadors for Christ and for Hales Corners Lutheran Church. And we want to be able to pray over these folks as we send them on their way. So will you join me in prayer? Let's pray. Dear Lord God, Heavenly Father, I ask you that you would guide, protect, guard, deliver to and back home again these brothers and sisters in Christ. And from this event, in this time, may they never be the same again. May they experience your love, your provision, the need to depend totally upon you and upon one another in this journey before them. Protect, guard, guide, and deliver them back home again. But dear Lord, we ask you that you would keep their eyes on the fact that this is not about them. It's about the people whose lives can be touched with the gospel of Jesus Christ, by meeting human need as a way to open doors for your love, by sharing their faith with gentleness and respect, and inviting people who may not yet know Jesus into a relationship with him and into a relationship with the church in that place. We ask you, dear God, that you would use these brothers and sisters in Christ as instruments in your hands for the building up of the kingdom of heaven. And so we send them from us in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Please keep them in your prayers as they go forward. Thank you guys very, very much. Thank you. We greet one another with the love and the joy and the peace that we have in Christ.
Please be seated. Already, we'd like to invite the children to come forward for the children's message. It is awesome to see all of you here this morning. So I'm wondering, I want to take a look at this. Can you see this? take a look at this. What do you think this is? What do you think this is that's in my hand? Everyone see that? What do you think it is? It's a note. All right. What do you think it is?
From a birthday party.
Yeah, this is an invitation to a birthday party. Have you ever received one of these, an invitation to come to a birthday party? Yeah, that's pretty cool, right? Pretty cool to get invited to come to someone's birthday party. Your brother has a birthday? Hey, that's a good thing. So let me ask you this question. When you go to birthday parties, what do you love? What do you like about birthday parties? What are the favorite things that happen there? What's one of your favorite things? Your brother just turned 7. That is outstanding. And I bet, did he have a party? And you went there? Okay. Your dad gave him a dirt bike? Wow. I wish I was invited. All right. What do you love about birthday parties? Oh, just give me one. So you get cake. We love cake, right? So you get food at birthday parties. You like cake. Pastor Keith likes cake.
We love cake.
Pastor Joe likes cake even more.
We love
cake. It's true, isn't it? What else? What else do you love about birthdays? Yeah, what do you love? Presents. Amen. Like the dirt bike. We love presents. Give me one more. What do you love?
Throw you under the bus.
You're turning 6 on your birthday. That is just outstanding. Do you have something?
I'm going to turn 5.
You're going to turn 5. Praise God. We are all going to have birthdays. So let me kind of review. So you love the gifts, the presents that happen at birthday parties. You love all the food. And do you like seeing friends there? And sometimes there's family. So you get to see people that you love and that you enjoy. Well, you know what? As you think about being invited to birthday parties, you know, we've been talking about this entire month. We've been talking about J2e3, or as I like to call it, J2e3. And I like to call it that because Pastor Wood hates it when I do that. But you see, what that means is Jesus to everyone, everywhere, every day. And you know, sometimes we think when we say that, well, that means just kind of going out into the world and sharing Jesus. But you know, there's something that's even easier, especially for you, and it's kind of like this invitation. Because you can invite your friends and people in your family, you can invite them to come here to church. Because here at church, we hear about God's great love for us. We hear about how Jesus died on the cross because he loved us so much. And you know what else is cool about church? There are gifts, there are food, and there are people that you love here. Think about it. There are gifts. God gives his gifts in worship. We have the waters of baptism. That's a gift. God's word itself is a gift. Today, we're going to have a holy meal in the Holy Communion and the sacrament of the altar today. And also, I know some of you are really excited, because especially today, because Pastor Chad's getting ordained. And we're also honoring Pastor Johnson for 50 years in the ministry. We're going to have donuts.
Donuts.
I know. We're going to have donuts. And so there's food. But there's also brothers and sisters in Christ that we grow with. And so remember, you can invite people to this place so that they can be sent back out to share the love of Jesus in the world. Jesus to everyone, everywhere, every day. Will you guys pray with me? Fold your hands and echo my prayer. Dear God.
Dear God.
Thank you.
Thank you.
For loving me.
For loving me.
In Jesus.
In Jesus.
Help me, dear God.
Help me, dear God.
By your Spirit.
By your Spirit.
To invite others.
To invite others.
To this place.
To this place.
So they can hear.
So they can hear.
About you.
About you.
Your love for them.
And your love for them.
And that they can tell others.
And they can tell others.
Amen.
Amen.
Hey, thanks for coming up. If you are going to Children's Church, just head right out back. Otherwise, go back to your families. If you don't know, go check with Mom and Dad.
Hi, you guys. As the children make their way back, we have been in this month-long journey through this sermon series called J2e3. And in that journey together, we have been hearing about one specific way. Every single one of you have a myriad of ways to share God's love every day with people everywhere all along your way. And then we as a congregation have a specific thing on the other side of the world in Kenya that we are building up to so that we can fulfill Acts 1:8 that says, you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem, Judea, Samaria, and to the very ends of the earth. And so with your tithes and your offerings this day, as I said before, we need to finish the year strong, and this is the last day to help us do that. But also, there is this opportunity that if you choose to give to this project in Kenya, we're about a quarter of the way there, and our hope is that we will reach the $100,000 mark. Oh Lord, we need to pray. Will you pray with me? Let's pray. Dear Lord God, Heavenly Father, you've been so generous to each and every one of us. So generous that you gave your only begotten Son for each one of us. Inspire our lives, our faith, that you would turn us away from us and our own stuff to you and to the world around us, so that you would inspire in us the love that you have given to us, and that you would use our lives to make a huge impact upon the world for Christ. Right now, right here, is an opportunity for us to reach out in generosity so that with the tithes and the offerings we give, need is met as a way to open doors for your love. And then that love is shared by people who will share their faith with gentleness and respect. And then we, as a family of God, will have a mission and a ministry where we will be excited to invite people to this place where he pours his grace out on us. And so, dear Lord, inspire your people first to give in response to your great love, but then also to give to the need of the mission and the ministry that you have in mind for us. In your name we pray. Amen. The tithes and the offerings will be gathered and received.
Christians joy to see, only
It was 50 years ago today that Keith Johnson knelt before the Lord and was ordained. 50 years ago, brother, ordained into the public ministry. 35 of those years have been right here with you. So, have any of you been here? Raise your hand if you've been here that whole time, all 35 years. Keith and Sylvia, would you come up here? Welcome them. Welcome. On a day that we celebrate these milestones for Keith and Sylvia, it is just amazing to all of us that this is 50 years to the day, and then later in the service we're going to ordain on Chad on day one, day 50 years, and we rejoice over who you have been, who you are, and who you will be among us. We rejoice over the model that you have been of what holy marriage looks like, that it ain't perfect, but you both are bent toward forgiveness. Has he ever done anything wrong?
Have you?
Okay. Nobody heard that. No. Yes, ma'am. has she ever done anything wrong?
Yes.
A silent pastor only comes from years of wisdom. And so bent toward forgiveness, bent toward sacrificial commitment, toward selflessness, toward one another with Christ as the heart and the head and the core of a marriage, they have been a wonderful model for us and will continue to be a great model for us about what holy marriage looks like. And mission and ministry, God has used this man of God and this woman of God to touch the lives of the people of God with his love. And so we love you, and we thank God for your service and for your ministry and for your partnership in the gospel and your friendship. And we have something that the people of God have put together here. It is a scrapbook with all kinds of stories of times when your life has touched their lives, and there are pictures. When you were like from 50 years ago at your ordination, you were like, dude, you were.
Yes, he was.
Yeah, praise God. Brothers, you come on up here. Let's pray over these two. Dear Lord God, Heavenly Father, I thank you for Keith and Sylvia. I thank you for their service to you, for their service to one another, for their sacrificial commitment, for the forgiveness and the holy marriage that they model for us. We ask you, dear Lord, that you would pour grace and blessing out upon them as they continue in strength to serve you in the world and in the church today. And I ask you, dear Lord, that you would continue to bless as they serve you in the ministry that you have for them among us. All this we ask, dear Lord, in your name, your Son's most holy and precious name. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Welcome them again. We rejoice for the couple. Chad, would you come forward, please? Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, wow, Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, Chad has been called by the Lord of the church into the office of the public ministry of the Word of God and the sacraments of our Lord Jesus Christ. He has prepared himself for this ministry by prayer and careful study. He has been examined and declared ready and prepared to undertake this sacred responsibility. And by the guidance of the Holy Spirit, he has, in the church's normal order, been called to be one of your pastors at Hales Corners Lutheran Church. He is now presented to be ordained and consecrated to this office established by God. Hear what the Holy Scriptures say concerning the office of the public ministry.
From John 21. When they had finished eating, Jesus said to Simon Peter, "Simon, son of John, do you love me more than these?" "Yes, Lord," he said, "you know that I love you." Jesus said, "Feed my lambs." Again, Jesus said, "Simon, son of John, do you love me?" He answered, "Yes, Lord, you know that I love you." Jesus said, "Take care of my sheep." The third time he said to him, "Simon, son of John, do you love me?" Peter was hurt because Jesus asked him for the third time, "Do you love me?" He said, "Lord, you know all things. You know that I love you." Jesus said, "Feed my sheep."
From Paul's first letter to Timothy. Do not neglect your gift, which was given you through prophecy when the body of elders laid their hands on you. Be diligent in these matters. Give yourself wholly to them, so that everyone may see your progress. Watch your life and your doctrine closely. Persevere in them, because if you do, you will save both yourself and your hearers.
Here are the words that Paul wrote to Timothy, young pastor. From the third chapter, here is a trustworthy saying: whoever aspires to be an overseer desires a noble task. Now the overseer is to be above reproach, faithful to his wife, temperate, self-controlled, respectable, hospitable, able to teach, not given to drunkenness, not violent, but gentle, not quarrelsome, not a lover of money. He must manage his own family well, and see that his children obey him, and he must do so in a manner worthy of full respect. If anyone does not know how to manage his own family, how can he take care of God's church? He must not be a recent convert, or he may become conceited and fall under the same judgment as the devil. He must also have a good reputation with outsiders, so that he will not fall into disgrace and into the devil's trap. The word of the Lord.
Chad, hear these words from Ephesians chapter 4. So Christ himself gave the apostles, the prophets, the evangelists, the pastors and teachers to equip his people for works of service so that the body of Christ may be built up. Chad from 1 Peter chapter 5. Be shepherds of God's flock that is under your care, watching over them not because you must, but because you are willing, as God wants you to be, not pursuing dishonest gain, but eager to serve, not lording it over those entrusted to you, but being examples to the flock. And when the chief shepherd appears, you will receive the crown of glory that will never fade away.
God gathers his church by and around his holy word, and also grants it growth and increase. That this may be done, he has established the office of the public ministry into which you have been called and are now to be ordained and consecrated by prayer and the laying on of hands. In the presence of God and of this congregation, I now ask you, do you believe the canonical books of the Old and New Testament to be the inspired word of God and the only infallible rule of faith and practice? If so, then answer, I do.
I do.
Do you accept the Apostles' Nicene and Athanasian creeds as faithful testimonies to the truth of Holy Scripture? And do you reject all the errors which they condemn? If so, then answer, I do.
I do.
Do you solemnly promise that you will perform the duties of your office in accord with our confessions, and that all your teaching and your administration of the sacraments will be in conformity with the Holy Scriptures? If so, then answer, I do.
I do.
Will you faithfully instruct both young and old in the chief articles of the Christian doctrine? And will you forgive the sins of those who repent? And will you promise never to divulge the sins confessed to you? Will you minister faithfully to the sick and dying? Will you demonstrate to the church a constant and ready ministry, admonishing the people to a lively confidence in Christ and holy missional living? If so, then answer, I will with the help of God.
I will with the help of God.
Finally, will you adorn the office of the public ministry with a holy life? If so, then answer, I will, the Lord helping me through the power and the grace of His Holy Spirit.
I will, the Lord helping me through the power and the grace of His Holy Spirit. Amen.
Chad Kogakiewicz, I ordain and consecrate you to the office of the public ministry in the one holy Christian and apostolic church, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. And now the pastors will come forward for a blessing.
Chad, what a day to celebrate your beginning in ministry, as I celebrate many years. I know the gift of the Spirit be with you, and watch over and bless you. Also with the words of the psalmist, the Lord is my light, my salvation, whom shall I fear? The Lord is the stronghold of my life, of whom shall I be afraid? One thing I ask, wait for the Lord. Be strong and take courage. Wait for the Lord.
Chad, from the prophet Micah, act justly, love mercy, and walk humbly with your God. May you, as an ordained pastor, may you act justly following your Savior Jesus. May you love mercy and proclaim it often. And may you, in everything that you do, do it humbly as a pastor in this place.
Chad, hear these words from John chapter 10. There were people that wandered over and they saw Jesus at work, and they said this of John the Baptizer. They said, John did no miracle, but everything that John said about this man Jesus was true, and many put their faith in him that day. May your life lead such a testimony that when people meet Jesus for the first time, they know who they're meeting because of who you have claimed him to be. Go in peace.
There are some days that are better than others. This guy hates being touched, so the laying on of hands is just fantastic. In Acts 3, Peter and John are walking along. They go to the gate called Beautiful, and they see a man sitting there. And their words to him are words you can use in your entire life. Gold or silver, I do not have. True? But in the name of Jesus, rise and walk, for I bring something far greater than money in your pocket. The man leaves, excited, jumping around, praising the name of the Lord. This is the joy that you get to bring to people every single day. Do it faithfully and cheerfully.
I have to say this. As I look around here, I think I'm in a time warp. I haven't been here on a Sunday in a year, and y'all are sitting in the same places that you were 1 year ago, except for those of you who are visitors or new members. This is amazing. Chad, St. Paul writes in Romans chapter 1, I am not ashamed of the gospel of Christ, for it is the power of God to salvation. Your life has already been that way as a teacher and a principal. And I ask you now to carry forth that same blessing as you become a pastor, to touch the lives of people, not being ashamed of the gospel of Christ.
Katie, would you come forward?
Dear Lord God, Heavenly Father, I ask you that you would pour grace and blessing out upon this man of God and upon this woman of God, that in the midst of serving you as pastor, in the midst of serving you as a woman of God, in the midst of serving you in this holy marriage, that you would give to them blessing and grace, guard and protect and enlighten their home and their children and their family, that serving in this place would be a blessing, and that we together as a family of God would be a blessing to them. Hold on to them and hold them up in the victory that you have bought for them in the midst of the demands of every day of serving you as a pastor in this place. I ask you, dear God, that you would be with them both. Give to them wisdom and perseverance and patience and discernment. How it is that they navigate all of the changes and the chances and the challenges of serving you. I ask you, dear Lord, that you would be with them both and that you would bind them together so that we would have a model in our lives together of what a holy marriage looks like. We ask you, dear Lord, that you would be with them both and pour your grace out upon them in this new season of their life together. In your name we pray. Amen. Amen. You want to go ahead and stand? Turn and face the folks. God has given to us the opportunity this day to rejoice together as a family of God. And so we have questions. We have a question for the family of God. Will you, assembled here as God's people and speaking for the whole church, receive Pastor Chad as a servant of Christ, a minister of word and sacrament, given the church to serve God's people with the gospel of grace and salvation? If so, then shout, we will. Go, therefore, and join us as a shepherd of the Good Shepherd's flock. Proclaim the word of God, administer the sacraments, offer prayer for all God's people, instruct, watch over, and guide the flock under your care. Do it not for earthly gain, but with great joy, for you have been called not to lordship, but to service. And when the chief shepherd appears, you will receive the crown of glory that will never fade away. The Almighty and most merciful God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, bless and preserve you. Amen. Amen. Welcome them. Now, after worship today, I would remind you that there are donuts. They'll stay standing. There are donuts, and then also there are two more scrapbooks back there that need to be filled out. One for Chad, one for Keith, one for Chad and Katie, one for Keith and Sylvia. And so stop, fill out a note, write them a note on the scrapbook, and eat donuts, brothers and sisters in Christ. It is our gift to you this day. And now we sing together as we pray the Lord's Prayer.
God's word is clear. All of us have sinned and we fall short of the glory of God. And so we take a moment to search our hearts and make confession of our sins as we prepare for Holy Communion. Gracious God, our sins are too heavy to carry, too real to hide, and too deep to undo. We pray that you would set us free from a past that we cannot change and open to a future in which we can be changed, and that you would grant us grace to grow more and more in your likeness and image. We pause for a moment of silent confession, seeking Christ's forgiveness for the sins that we name in our hearts and in our minds. In this holy gift, you receive the forgiveness of sins. Listen, be reminded. Our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, on the same night in which he was betrayed, took bread, and after he had given thanks, he gave it to the disciples, saying, "Take and eat, this is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me."
In the same way also, he took the cup after supper, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink ye all of it. This cup is the New Testament in my blood, which is shed for you for the forgiveness of sins. This do as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." We examine ourselves and we see our sin and we see our need for our Savior, and our Savior meets us here that you would experience absolution, that you would experience forgiveness. He meets with you, bread, wine, body, blood, for the forgiveness of your sins and the strengthening of your faith in him as your Savior. If you truly believe that he is present here for you, for your forgiveness, and for the strengthening of your walk with him in the world today, then come, for these are the gifts of God prepared for the people of God.
Thank you.
Now may this true body and blood keep you steadfast in the true faith to life everlasting. Amen. Next slide. As God's family, we are called and gathered to worship, grow, and be sent to make a difference in the world for Christ. Go out now, taking Jesus to everyone, everywhere, every day.